Hello viewers, during our previous session, we initiated a numerical problem to understand how final accounts are prepared considering various adjustments. Considering the same problem, today we will have an insight into how various adjustments are given effect and final accounts are prepared after giving due effect to the adjustment. To have a clear understanding of the numerical problem, you can refer the previous session. And today we will give the effect to various adjustments. Let's start with the same. Let's take the first adjustment. Value of stock on 31st of March 2015 was rupees 30,500. I hope you know that closing stock is reported at two places. That is sure that all adjustments will have two effects, right? So as far as closing stock is concerned, this 30,500 will be reported once on the credit side of trading account, and then it is reported as a current asset in the balance sheet. Then the next item, salary due but not paid, was rupees 4000. I hope you understand we are talking about outstanding salaries. As outstanding expenses are added in the concerned expense that you learnt in the adjustment. So, what you can see on the screen is this outstanding salary of rupees 4000 has been added in the salary of rupees 35,850 given in the inner column, so as to give effect to this adjustment. That was the first adjustment. The second part is, you understand outstanding expenses are liabilities on the business. So, this 4000 rupees has been reported as a current liability in your balance sheet, the second effect. Moving on to the third one, wages paid in advance was rupees 6000. Now, this is the opposite kind of adjustment. This is a prepaid expense. I hope you remember that prepaid expenses are deducted from the concerned expense. As you can see on your screen, this prepaid wages of 6000 has been deducted from the manufacturing wages of 34,500 reported in the inner column to give first effect to this adjustment. Second effect, as prepaid expenses are current assets, so it is reported as a current asset in your balance sheet. Moving to the next adjustment, it says commission earned but not received is rupees 1000. This is accrued commission. I hope you understand that. Accrued incomes are to be added in the concerned incomes, you know that. So, as you go to your profit or loss account, what you can see is the commission received of 1400 has been increased for this 1000 rupees of accrued commission as an addition. As far as second effect is concerned, it is same as prepaid expenses. Accrued incomes are also reported as current assets in the balance sheet. Next is, interest on investment includes rupees 300 related to next year. Now, I hope you understand this is advance income. You have received 300 rupees in advance. Advance incomes are to be deducted from the concerned incomes, recall that. So, as you see your profit or loss account, your interest on investment of 5600 reported in inner column has been reduced for this 300 rupees received in advance. So, you can see minus 300 on your screen. For the second effect, as you have received this income in advance, it is a liability upon you. So, see your balance sheet on the screen, and you can see this interest on investment of rupees 300 received in advance has been reported as advance interest on your current liabilities. Moving ahead, we have provide for interest on capital at the rate of 8% per annum. Capital of rupees 50,000 has been introduced on 1st of July 2014. Now, this call for understanding the adjustment in calculative manner. See on your screen how interest on capital has been calculated, and then we will discuss the effect. As the total capital is 3,80,000 rupees, what is reported on your trial balance, and the additional information says capital of rupees 50,000 has been introduced on 1/7/2014. It implies that Out of rupees 380,000, 50,000 has been introduced during the year. And in the beginning of the year, that is on day 1, that is 1st April 2014, your opening capital was 330,000. Now, this 330,000, the opening capital is entitled for full year's interest, that is for full year. So, we have charged interest of 8% for full year on this 330,000, that amounts to 26,400 rupees as you calculate. Moving ahead, rupees 50,000 has been introduced on 1st of July 14. So, from 1st of July 14 to 31st of March 15, that means this capital remains in business for 9 months. So, it is entitled for interest of 9 months. So, on 50,000 rupees at the rate of 8%, when you calculate interest for 9 months, as you can see on the screen, it amounts to rupees 3000. That means, total interest on capital is 29,400 rupees, that is 26,400 plus 3000. Now, once you have calculated this amount, let us talk about the adjustment effect. As interest on capital is an expense for business, an indirect expense, it is reported on the debit side of your profit or loss account. You can see on the screen. And the second effect of this is that we are going to add this in the amount of capital in the balance sheet as it is an income to be received by the owner of the business. So, we are adding this in the owner's capital. I hope that is clear to you. Moving to the next one, we have charged interest on drawings at the rate of 6% per annum. Now, drawings are rupees 5000, we have already seen that. There is no information on when drawings are made it. So, we will assume to provide interest for the full year. As you calculate interest of 6% on drawings of 5000 rupees for full year, that will be 300 rupees, 5000 into 6%. So, interest of 300 rupees on drawings is an income for the business. So, will be on the credit side of your profit or loss account as an indirect income. That is the first effect. And second effect is, as you have to receive this income from the owner. So, we are going to adjust it in the capital only by deducting it. As interest on capital is added to capital, interest on drawings is deducted from capital like drawings only. So, that is clear to you. The next item on adjustments, charge depreciation on plant and machinery at the rate of 10% per annum and at the rate of 15% per annum on motor car. Motor car has been purchased on 1/1/2015. Let us calculate the amount of depreciation first and then we will move ahead to the effect. As far as plant and machinery is concerned, there is no additional information apart from this 10% depreciation. So, we will assume that this is the plant and machinery which is brought forward from previous year right in the beginning. So, it is entitled for full year's depreciation. As you can see your plant and machinery, it is 2 lakh rupees. 10% of 2 lakh rupees is 20,000 rupees. This is the depreciation on plant and machinery. Moving ahead to motor car. Motor car has been purchased on 1/1/15. That means, it will be entitled for depreciation of 3 months only, that is January, February and March. The value of motor car is 1,20,000. At the rate of 15%, when you calculate depreciation for 3 months, what you can see is it amounts to rupees 4,500. So, we have depreciation of plant and machinery of rupees 20,000. And depreciation of motor car of rupees 4500. As depreciation is an expense for the business, both these expenses are indirect as these are not factory machines, they are office used machineries like plant and machinery. As it is not informed, we will take it part of office machinery. And secondly, motor car, you understand that is a general use item, that is not a factory item. So, both these depreciations will be shown as an expense on your profit or loss account, assuming they are not connected to the factory activities. So, this is the first effect. They are reported on the debit side of your profit or loss account as you can see on the screen. The second effect is the value of depreciation is deducted from the concerned assets. So, let us move to the balance sheet. As you can see the balance sheet, plant and machinery of rupees 2 lakh reported in the inner column is to be reduced for rupees 20,000 of depreciation. And then motor car of rupees 1,20,000 reported in the inner column in the same category of assets is to be reduced for the depreciation of 4,500. I hope that is clear to you. Let us see the ninth adjustment relating to goods withdrawn by owner worth rupees 5,000 for personal use. As far as goods withdrawn by owner are concerned, it is as good as drawings. So, first effect is we are going to deduct it from capital in the balance sheet like drawings. And second effect, as it is connected to goods account, I hope you remember, it is to be deducted from the value of purchases in the trading account. So, you can see trading account on your screen, we are deducting this rupees 5,000 goods withdrawn by owner for personal use from the purchase value. Similar adjustment is the next one, that is goods worth rupees 10,000 were given in charity. Now, charity is a loss for business, indirect loss. So, this 10,000 will be reported on profit or loss account debit side as a loss. And second effect, I hope you understand, goods are to be deducted for rupees 10,000 in trading account from the value of total purchases. Next item is goods worth rupees 12,000 were distributed as free samples. Now, as it is free samples, it is a kind of advertisement expenses. Advertisement is considered as an indirect expense. So, first effect is you are going to show this 12,000 as an indirect expense on your profit or loss account using the term to advertisements or maybe to goods distributed as free samples. The second effect is clear, that is to be deducted from the value of purchases in the trading account. See on your screen, from the purchases of the given value, we are also deducting rupees 12,000 along with the other adjustment for the goods distributed as free samples. Moving ahead, the next adjustment, goods worth rupees 20,000 were given to employees under service terms. This is a kind of salaries payment. So, shall affect your profit or loss account. So, this 20,000 will be reported on the debit side of your profit or loss account as indirect expense on salaries. You can use the term to salaries or you can also write to goods given to employees, one in the same thing. The second effect, I hope you will be understanding that this will be deducted from the value of purchases in the trading account. You can see on the screen. All the items of adjustment has been highlighted so that you can understand these are because they are adjustments. Moving to the next one, goods worth rupees 25,000 were destroyed in an accident. Though goods were insured, insurance company accepted only 60% claim. Now, recall, we have understood this adjustment in greater details. When goods are destroyed for some abnormal reason, it is an abnormal loss. But what is important is to construe whether there is loss to the firm or not. As you can see, these goods are insured, but insurance company is accepting only 60% claim. That means there is 40% loss to the firm. So, that means 40% of the destroyed value, that is 25,000 into 40%, 10,000 rupees. Is actual loss to the business. So, shall be reported as an indirect loss on your profit or loss account, that is what you can see on the screen. As far as 60% claim is concerned, this claim is not yet received, only accepted by the insurance company. So, insurance claim will appear as a current asset in your balance sheet. So, I hope you are clear. For the loss, we will divide it in two parts. The claim accepted part is reported as current asset in balance sheet and remaining part, that is actual loss to the business, is reported on the debit side of profit or loss account. This is the first effect divided in two parts. As far as second effect is concerned, I hope you are understanding it that like other adjustments on goods, these goods of 25,000 rupees also are to be deducted from the value of purchases given in the trading account, as you can see on the screen. Let us move to our next adjustment, that is, bank loan has been taken on 1/10/2014. If you can see the item on trial balance, that was 9% bank loan informed for the value given. That value was, I believe, 1,15,000 rupees. Now, what is informed to you is this loan of 1,15,000 rupees has been given on 1st of October 2014 by the bank. So, it is an indirect kind of information that tells you that you shall charge interest on this bank loan from 1st October 14 to 31st March 15. That calls for 6 months of interest from October to March. Now, what is important is, do we have interest on bank loan somewhere on trial balance? I believe there is no item called interest on bank loan on your trial balance. This implies that you have not paid any interest on bank loan till date. So, that means your interest for 6 months is outstanding. Let us first calculate the amount. The amount of bank loan is 1,15,000. At the rate of 9% for 6 months, as you calculate, it amounts to 5,175 rupees. Now, as it is an outstanding expense, it shall be reported on your profit or loss account because it is an indirect expense. So, see your profit or loss account on the screen. You can see interest on bank loan 5,175 reported on the debit side. This is the first effect. Moving to the second effect, you know that either this is to be shown as an outstanding expense under current liabilities, or you can also add it in the amount of bank loan given in the balance sheet. As of now, what I am doing is, I am showing it separately as an outstanding expense under current liabilities. So, that will imply bank loan can be directly shown in the outer column for 1,15,000 rupees. I hope you understand that how this has been given effect. The last adjustment, one of the very important adjustments considered in preparation of final accounts, that reads like further bad debts amounted to rupees 1200. Maintain a provision for bad debts at the rate of 5% on debtors. Now, recall that I ask you to hold two items on your trial balance. One was bad debts and another was provision for bad debts. Provision for bad debts was rupees 5000 and bad debts was rupees 11,400. Recall this adjustment. When we maintain a provision for bad debts, we do not show bad debts on profit or loss account directly. They are rather written off through provision for bad debts account. So, as you go with this adjustment, what you can see is you have to write off bad debts of rupees 1200 given outside the trial balance, as well as bad debts of rupees 11,400 given in the trial balance. That means, bad debts of rupees 12,600 are to be written off. Then, you are been asked to maintain a provision of bad debts at the rate of 5% on debtors. What is the amount of debtors on trial balance? I hope 78,200, right? Now, recall that before calculating provision of 5%, first we have to write off additional bad debts of rupees 1200 from this. So, as you reduce 78,200 for 1,200, the amount eligible for bad debt provision is 77,000 rupees. As you calculate 5% of 77,000 rupees, that amounts to 3,850. That means, the total provision needed by you is 12,600 for bad debt purpose and 3,850 for maintaining closing provision on bad debts. So, in all total provision needed by you is 16,450 rupees, out of which you already have provision of rupees 5,000 given in the trial balance, which you have held for the sake of this adjustment. So, as you reduce this provision requirement, 16,450 minus 5,000, you understand that new provision to be created is 11,450 rupees. Now, let us talk about the effect. The first effect is that this new provision creation of 11,450 is to be reported on the debit side of your profit or loss account as to provision for bad debts, because this year this is the amount of provision that you have created. Then the second effect is that the provision that remains in balance, that is 3,850 rupees, that is to be shown as a provision for bad debts in balance sheet under the head current liabilities. So, you can see on the balance sheet under current liabilities, we have provision for bad debts amounting 3850. I am sure you are clear why it is 3850. We have understood it in greater details in the immediately preceding session, session 25. And the third effect, I mean going with the bad debts effect, what you can see is in the balance sheet under the current assets, when you reported your debtors for 78,200 in the inner column, they have been reduced for further bad debts of rupees 1200, so as to show the amount of 77,000 rupees in the outer column. This is the overall effect of this adjustment on provision for bad debts and bad debts. Now, once you have done this, what you can see is your final accounts are appearing like this. As you see the trading account, opening stock is reported in the outer column, purchases which were reported to be 18,37,140 in the inner column has been reduced for 5 adjustments, withdrawn by owner 5,000, given in charity 10,000, distributed as free samples 12,000, given to employees 20,000. And destroyed in accident 25,000. Once you deduct all these values from 18,37,140, the remaining amount of 17,65,140 has been reported in the outer column. Then we have sales return, the next item, for 3,100. Manufacturing wages have been reported in the inner column for 34,500. And prepaid amount of 6,000 has been deducted. So, outer column will report 28,500 rupees, the difference. Remaining items are directly appearing in the outer column: freight, manufacturing expenses, fuel and power, and factory lighting. On the credit side, we have already discussed the three items: sales, purchase, returns, and closing stock. Now, what is important is to close the trading account. Now, closing this, what you can see apparently, credit side has a higher total. So, we will first add these three items on credit side. As you add these three items on credit side, it totals to 25,28,090 rupees. Now, let us move to the debit side. The items on the debit side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 items. When you add this 8 items, it totals up to 18,82,530 rupees. And the difference of these two values, that is credit total of 25,28,090 rupees minus debit total of 18,82,530 rupees, the difference is 6,45,560 rupees, that is your gross profit. Because credit side is totaling more than the debit side, the firm has got gross profit. Once you are done with this, let us move to our next statement, that is profit or loss account. So, see on the credit side of your profit or loss account, the gross profit of 6,45,560 is reported. Then Commission received 1400 is increased for accrued commission of 1000 and outer column reports 2400. Similarly, interest on investments of 5600 is reduced for advance interest of 300 and remaining, that is 5300, is reported in the outer column. And interest on drawings we have already discussed, 300 rupees reported in the outer column. As you see the debit side, salaries have been increased for outstanding salaries of 4000. So, outer column is reporting salaries of 39850. All the other adjustments have been already reported on the external amount column. So, I am not mentioning them separately. What is important is, again you can see your credit side seems to have a higher total. So, first we will total the credit side, higher side, and then we will come to debit side. As you total the four items on the credit side, it totals to 6,53,560 rupees. Now, moving to the debit side, as you total up all the items on the debit side, it totals to 1,86,225 rupees. The difference of this two, that is 6,53,560 minus 1,86,225, is 4,67,335 rupees, and that is your net profit. I hope you understand the difference of these two sides report or represent the net profit of the business. Let us move to the balance sheet now. As you see the balance sheet, there are various items on the asset side and others on the liability side. Let us first screen the asset side. What you can observe is plant and machinery was reported to be 2 lakh in the inner column, has been reduced for depreciation of 20,000 rupees, and external column shows the remaining value of 1,80,000 rupees. The next four items, that is furniture, building, goodwill, land, have been reported directly in the outer column. Motor car of 1,20,000 was reported in the inner column. As reduced for depreciation of 4,500, the remaining value of 1,15,500 is shown in the outer column. Current assets, sundry debtors of 78,200 reduced for further bad debts of 1200. Has been reported to be rupees 77,000 in the outer column. All the remaining items we have already discussed, they are already on the outer amount column. And now we can see the liabilities and capital side. The first item, the most important one, capital, it began with balance of 3,80,000 taken from trial balance. It has been adjusted for drawings of rupees 5000 deducted, interest on capital of rupees 29,400 added, interest on drawings of rupees 300 deducted, goods withdrawn of rupees 5000 deducted, and increased for net profit of 4,67,335 rupees. Once you put up all these calculations, the closing capital of the business amounts to 8,66,435 rupees reported in the outer column. I have already told you bank loan we are going to show 1,15,000 directly in the outer column, as interest on bank loan has been reported as a liability. All the remaining current liabilities also we have discussed. Once this is done, now, you have to put up the total to both the sides of the balance sheet, and if everything is in order, this shall by default tally, because you had a tallied trial balance. So, there has to be a tallied balance sheet as well. As you put up total to all the items on the asset side, it appears to 10,39,320 rupees. The same is the total of all the items on the liabilities and capital side as well. That means, things have been done in a proper manner and there is no clerical or any other kind of error committed. I am sure you have properly understood the way final accounts are prepared considering various important adjustments. though these days we have ready-made softwares that take care of the accounting function and deal with the majority of the technical aspect of accounting. But as an aspirant of accounting vocation, it is very important for you to understand the conceptual part of accounting function. I am sure this module on financial accounting has been helped in understanding the conceptual part of accounting process. By this, we come to conclusion of this last session and this module on financial accounting. In case of any doubt relating to any part of the entire module, you can mail me your queries at the mail ID given on your screen. My best wishes. Thank you so much.